Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure to have you back with us in Hereford. We thank you very much for the time you've devoted to the preparation of the music that you're offering in worship here. And we hope very much that you enjoy your time with us today. Our service continues now as the choir sings Psalms 126 and 127, which you'll find towards the back of the Book of Common Prayer. We invite you to be seated. our service on earth, and are not their days like the days of a labourer, like a slave who longs for the shadow, and like labourers who look for their wages, so I am allotted months of emptiness, and nights of misery are apportioned to me. When I lie down, I say, when shall I rise? But the night is long, and I am full of tossing until dawn. My flesh is clothed with worms and dirt. My skin hardens, then breaks out again. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle, and come to their end without hope. Remember that my life is a breath. My eye will never again see good. The eye that beholds me will see me no more. While your eyes are upon me, I shall be gone. As the cloud fades and vanishes, so those who go down to Sheol do not come up. They return no more to their houses, nor do their places know them any more. Therefore I will not restrain my mouth. I will speak in the anguish of my spirit. I will complain in the bitterness of my soul. Am I the sea or the dragon that you set a guard over me? When I say, my bed will comfort me, my couch will ease my complaint, then you scare me with dreams and terrify me with visions, so that I would choose strangling and death rather than this body. I loathe my life. I would not live forever. Let me alone, for my days are a breath. What are human beings that you make so much of them, that you set your mind on them, visit them every morning, test them every moment? Will you not walk away from me for a while? Let me alone until I swallow my spittle. If I sin, what do I do to you, you watcher of humanity? Why have you made me your target? Why have I become a burden to you? Why do you not pardon my transgression and take away my iniquity? For now I shall lie in the earth. You will seek me, but I shall not be. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. crowd believed God, and it was reckoned to him as righteousness. Now to one who works, wages are not reckoned as a gift, but as something due. But to one who without works trusts him and justifies the ungodly, such faith is reckoned as righteousness. So also David speaks of the blessedness of those to whom God reckons righteousness, irrespective of works. Blessed are those whose iniquities are forgiven, and whose sins are covered. Blessed is the one against whom the Lord will not reckon sin. Is this blessedness, then, pronounced only on the circumcised or also on the uncircumcised? We say faith was reckoned to Abraham as righteousness. How, then, was it reckoned to him? Was it before or after he had been circumcised? It was not after, but before he was circumcised. He received the sign of circumcision as a seal of the righteousness that he had by faith while he was still uncircumcised. The purpose was to make him the ancestor of all who believe without being circumcised, and who thus have righteousness reckoned to them. And likewise, the ancestor of the circumcised, who are not only circumcised, but who also followed the example of the faith that our ancestor Abraham had, for he was circumcised. It ends the second lesson.
Amen.
The anthem is then Elgar's setting of verses from chapter 2 of the book of the prophet Joel. Fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice. Sudan, Tanzania, Loving God, we look with compassion upon our brothers and sisters who go to bed hungry each night. Remove from us any sense of indifference or helplessness, so that through our prayers and our generosity, we may be responsive to their cries for help. By your grace, may they come to know that even in a time of crisis, they can never be cut off from the warmth and comfort of your love. Give courage and persistence to the aid agencies in their efforts to feed the hungry, and fire them with determination to rebuild lives devastated by drought, famine, and war, so that prosperity in every nation may be established to the glory of your holy name.
Amen.
In our diocesan cycle of prayer today, we are interceding for the parishes of Ross with Walford and Brampton Abbots. We pray for Timothy Jackson, Caroline Pascoe, John Davis, and David Thomas, the clergy serving in those parishes during the interregnum. For Colin Leggett, the associate priest, chaplain to commerce, industry, and business. For Fried Davis and Derek Glover, the benefice readers. And we pray too for the schools in that benefice during this half-term break. For Brampton Abbots Church School, Ashfield Park Primary School, St. Joseph's Roman Catholic Primary School, Walford Primary School, and John Curl High School. Pray for their head teachers, staff, governors, parents, and pupils. We also ask a blessing upon the work of Ross Community Hospital. Pray particularly for the doctors and nurses, for the ancillary staff, the patients, and all the volunteers who enable that community hospital to be a centre of healing. We're also asked to pray today for the work of the Environment Agency in its role of caring for the countryside and keeping waterways clear and healthy. We give thanks for its wisdom and experience in working with farmers and landowners to maintain the landscapes that we enjoy and to protect the environment from pollution or inappropriate exploitation. We ask a particular blessing upon those who are working to clean up the River Wye, returning it to a river that can sustain a rich and diverse ecology. We also give thanks for the opportunities of leisure presented by the countryside around us and the nearby national parks. We give you thanks, most gracious God, for the beauty of earth and sky and sea, for the richness of mountains and plains and rivers, for the songs of birds and the loveliness of wildflowers. We praise you for these good gifts and pray that we may safeguard them for future generations. Grant that we may continue to grow in our grateful enjoyment of your abundant creation, to the honour and glory of your holy name, now and forever. On this bank holiday, let us give thanks for all who work in the hotel and hospitality industry, enabling people to take holidays and to enjoy periods of relaxation and fellowship. We ask a blessing upon the work of Visit Herefordshire and all who encourage people to come to the marches for their recreation. We pray for the ministry of this cathedral church in welcoming pilgrims and visitors from all over the world, asking that they may find in this hallowed place not only a warm welcome, but also a sense of the loving presence of the living God. Help us, O God, to carry into our daily work your care for every part of human life, a genuine interest in every person with whom we have to do, and our calling as men and women commanded to shine as lights in the world. We ask this in the name of your Son, our Saviour. We unite these normal prayers with the intercessions that have been offered today at the shrine of St. Thomas of Hereford as we say together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all.